Go on, say it again. See what happens.
Well, I'm not here to fight you, but it's an argument you want. How do you know Sarah was your true love?
You're barking up the wrong fucking tree!
Just answer the damn question.
She made me happy! No one has ever made me that happy! No one!
And how do you know you'll never be that happy again, ever?
How could I be? It's the kind of thing that only comes along, like, once in a lifetime.
Maybe. But maybe not. You better drop the fucking greeting card bullshit and start talking sense, because I'm sick of this shit.
All right.
To Moya's ultimate true love, the one he was truly meant to be with, was Nagisa, right? But that's only true in one world. In other worlds, Tomoya was just as happy with Kyo, or Tomoyo, or Gatomi, I mean, fuck, the librarian, Yukine Miyazawa. Now, do you think any of those Tomoyas had any idea what Nagisa's Tomoya was going through? You think they had any inkling that they could have had better? Well, of course the hell they didn't. Each one of them achieved the happiness they needed. Which brings me to you. You think that, like Nagisa, Sarah's gone and you'll never get her back. But what if she isn't your Nagisa? What if she's like your Kyo or Tomoyo or Yukine? What if you haven't even met your Nagisa at all and you have no idea who she is or how happy you'll be when you do eventually meet her? Yes. Then if, when?
But see, that's the bullshit! There's no way you can possibly know that for sure!
Well, of course I can't know it, but I can believe it.
So can you!
It's up to you to believe in this, Will, because as much as I'd like to help you, it's not my life. I can't do this for you. Well, at the very least, I guess, I never thought about it that way.
Well, of course you didn't, you fucker. You've been standing around staring out windows and paraphrasing John Donne like an asshole.
Oh, yeah. Maybe you're right. You know, I was happy with her. I really was. But maybe there is more ahead. You know, this can't be the end of the road. If there's something else out there, damn it, I'm sure gonna find it. Maybe that's the best I can hope.
Shit. I just hallucinated all that, didn't I?
No, you didn't.
Great. Okay, I'm going insane.
No, you're not.
Get it, Casper!
We'll be right back. So, here we are at the end of the world. Well, let's go out with a bang then, shall we?
If I had known this was going to happen, I wouldn't have taken her with me. In the end, all I did was make her suffer.
That's right. It all started when I spoke to her that day. Maybe I shouldn't have said anything. If she hadn't met me, then she wouldn't.
You should probably just kill yourself. Either that or actually make a firm decision for once in your life.
Well, the robot child is apparently way ahead of Tomoya on this one and gives Fate a middle finger by trying to wake the girl. He manages to bring her to, unlocking a series of plot twists that can easily make your head spin if you're not careful.
Okay, go.
I had a dream just now, lying in the snow. I found out a lot of things. Things about you, things about me. Want me to tell you? We were from the same world, you and I.
Right, so A and B are members of C. Keep going.
Then that means we don't belong in this world after all. Let's go back together. Sorry. That sounds wonderful, but I have to stay here. Why? Because I'm not just another part of this world. I'm the world itself. If I leave this place, then the entire world will disappear. If that happens, all the lights will turn from hope to sorrow. Lights? The lights that are floating in the air? Yes. Each one of them represents the hope of someone in the other world. You are one of those lights yourself. The world's so close, yet so far away. Do you remember now? We've always been there, you and I. In the same town, in the same place. I see. It's been so long that you must have forgotten.
Another world? And there's another me there?
You haven't realized it yet? Even though you came from the other world, even though you exist there now, we were able to meet because you overcame the distance between our worlds.
Oh, shit. Okay, B is Tomoya. All right, got it.
Wait, I know that song.
You should. It's the song you always sang to me. Until we meet again, Daddy.
Get her, you stupid fop!
Nagisa! Nagisa, I'm right here. Don't leave me.
Meeting you was the best thing that ever happened to me. You made me so happy.
Thank you.
Alright, enough of the David Lynch shit. Just take us home already.
Nagisa.
Yep, that's right. Nagisa lives. Also, for some reason, the town starts shooting orbs of light out of its ass. You know, it'd be awesome if that could have happened, like, I don't know, 20 episodes ago? Anyway, before we get to this last bit, I want to show you how Nagisa totally spoiled the ending an entire series ago. Ready? Okay.
They set out on a long, long journey. And at the end...
And at the end?
They sing a song.
You serious?
Of course I am.
All right, I'll give you that, but I doubt she would have sang the big Dango family song.
Dango, 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 Dango family.
Dango, 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 Dango family.
Yeah, I bet you never noticed that, did ya?
With a
Well, now you know. Anyway, this ending sequence here that completely wraps the series up with a nice bow is absolutely beautiful. But probably the strongest part is what Nagisa says and how Tomoyo responds.
But even if it's wonderful, I guess it's not really a miracle, is it? After all, this sort of thing happens every day. People who live here love this town, and they find happiness here all the time. Even if it doesn't have thoughts, I think this town is still alive in its own way. I think it still loves the people who live here. I've grown up in this town. All of my memories and dreams are a part of it. In a way, I feel like it raised me.
So this town is like one big family, huh?
Yep, a big dango family.
Yeah. I think I'm finally starting to get that.
Yeah, it's pretty great. With everything finally resolved and Tomoya finally receiving the happy ending he deserves, he can finally see the town for what it really is, a place to love and be loved. So, how did this come to be? How do you make sense of any of what just happened? Well, I'm gonna give this my best shot.
A lot of what I'm about to say is influenced by Kotomi's comments earlier in the show that there could be any number of parallel worlds, so keep that in mind. To begin with, we'll start when Nagisa died. After her death, a part of Tomoya's spirit splintered off and created an alternate world in his head where he was forever stuck at the bottom of the school hill, agonizing endlessly over whether or not he should have talked to Nagisa. We know this is the case because in episode 16, Tomoya lets Nagisa walk away, but in episode 22, she's still standing next to him and walks past him again. So clearly, this is a world where Tomoya punishes himself time and time again for Nagisa's death. We'll call this one the cyclical world. Now pay attention because things are about to get complicated. When Yushio died, two things happened at once. Yushio was reborn as the illusionary world, and the girl in it was an extension of herself. However, through this process, she completely forgot that the only reason she wanted to make that world was to gather enough orbs of light to bring Tomoya, Nagisa, and her back together. Meanwhile, Tomoya's wish activated. This is what happens when Tomoya starts glowing and his orb of light floats off after Yushio dies. Tomoya made the same wish that Yushio did, although his wish was fulfilled via the Orb of Light because he was still alive. The majority of his spirit then traveled beyond the boundaries of space and time to the illusionary world where he existed as an Orb of Light. I know this is never seen or explicitly stated, but it's the only way that the little girl would be able to see him. She recognized him because he probably looked like the same Orb of Light that Tomoya used to get there in the first place. Without knowing why, Yushio set about building robots because of an unconscious desire to be with Tomoya again. However, the irony is that, even though neither of them realized it, they were already together and Tomoya was the robot.
The important thing to note here is that this world is completely independent of time and space. Remember, the story of Clannad takes place over the course of 8 years, and this girl and the robot never age a day. So they're basically in God mode the whole time. Lucky them.
During this time, the splinter of Tomoya's spirit that created the cyclical world remained there. When winter comes, it's not that the girl stops moving because it's winter, it's that winter comes because the girl is about to stop moving. All the spiritual energy that she's had to expend to keep the world running and send orbs of light to the other world has broken her down and she only has so much time left, which is why the world is ending. When the world does end, however, something even more complicated occurs.
Thanks to all the other Tomoyas in all the other worlds, the miracle is allowed to happen. And by the way, we know that these other worlds parallel to this one specifically exist not just because of Katomi's parents, but also because the Kyo and Tomoyo episodes are called Another World. Oh yeah, that.
As a result of that, when the world ends, the spirit of robot Tomoya rejoins with the last remaining splinter of himself in the cyclical world, where he finally realizes that being with Nagisa was never a mistake and runs to embrace her. And thusly, the miracle succeeds, and as the cyclical world collapses, Tamoya returns to the moment of its creation, Nagisa's death. However, because of the miracle, she lives on and Tamoya can finally be happy.
Phew! Well, I think that's finally gonna do it. Wait, what do you mean the episode's not over yet? Oh, crap.
Yeah, because that happy ending wasn't good enough, so here's one last scene with... Fuko.
How could you end the show without her?
She acts like an idiot, finds Yushio in the forest, and blah blah, we're done.
And that, ladies and gentlemen, is Clannad After Story. But, you might notice that we're running a little bit low on time. That's because I'm not finishing this up right here and now. I've got one final episode of this show to get through, and a whole lot of explanation to give as for why this is the greatest anime of all time. So join me next time for our finale, because whether you agree with me or not, you're not going to want to miss out. I guarantee it.